Today, I am sharing with you the best budget alternatives to expensive facial cleansers. Hi, my name is Lauren O'Connell, and I am the skincare stylist. Welcome. A few months ago, my husband found out some news that I know so many people in the world did, and that was he was getting a drastic pay cut to his salary. When he told me, I was panicking, I had anxiety, I couldn't sleep at night. Anyways, when he told me that he was getting a pay cut or he had gotten the pay cut, I just stopped spending money. That was my way of handling it. I was in panic mode and I said to myself, if we don't absolutely need it, I'm not buying it. And then I ran out of my face cleanser. Now, what am I gonna do? The face cleanser that I've always loved to use is the Dermalogica Intensive Moisture Cleanser. It's not cheap. This is $39, it is 5 ounces. That comes out to $7.34 per ounce. I needed to find an alternative. Now, here's the thing. I have a degree in biomechanical engineering. I have a master's of science in nursing. I have studied dermatology. If anyone can look at the ingredients and find cheaper alternatives that are even better than this one, it's me. And it has to be a good cleanser because I am maturing. I have mature skin. I'm 37 years old. My skin's very, very dry and it's prone to fine lines and wrinkles. So I had a mission and I succeeded. So today I'm sharing with you 5 awesome alternatives to this product, as well as 3 alternatives that I tried that were terrible. They're not expensive, but don't buy them anyway. Save your money. So let's get into the good ones starting now. The first cleanser I'm showing you probably is my favorite one. It is by The Ordinary, and this is their squalene cleanser. If you've watched any of my videos, you know how I feel about the ingredient squalene. I feel that everyone over the age of 25 should be adding squalene into their skincare routine. It has completely transformed my skin and it's really given me just such a nice glow and just really youthful looking skin. When I tried this product out, I have to say it pretty much completely mimicked and is better than the Dermalogica. It's also about half the price. This cleanser is $19.90 and it is 5.07 fluid ounces. That comes out to $3.92 per ounce. I do also just because I like to be completely transparent, this was given to me by The Ordinary. They saw my review of their hyaluronic acid in Cosmo. I'm a contributing beauty writer for Cosmopolitan Middle East magazine, and they reached out to me and they sent me a ton of products. I had them all over my Insta stories. Everyone was drooling over them. So this was given to me by them. However, if I did have this one on my own, and if I had purchased it, I would tell you the same thing. It is fantastic. The second cleanser is by Elave. This is an Irish brand, and this one is $21.57. It is 8.45 ounces, and let me just double check my math. It is $2.55 per ounce. Amazing price. Also, you can usually find these in Dubai for buy one, get one free. What I love about this product is that it is full of lots of gentle emollients and moisturizers, and there are no sodium lauryl sulfates in this product, which is something I never want to put on my skin because that really thins the skin out. And there's also no formaldehyde. Yes, formaldehyde in skincare products is a thing. I promise I'm having a video coming out on it soon. I really messed up my skin a few months ago with a Neutrogena product. I was trying some stuff out and my skin was so irritated and inflamed. I started to use this cleanser and it really helped to just rehab and nurture my skin. I highly, highly recommend it. The next cleanser is a very popular one. I'm sure you've heard of it. It's by CeraVe, and this is their hydrating facial cleanser for normal to dry skin. Once again, great ingredients, lots of fatty alcohols, glycerin. These are all ingredients that are going to help to just keep the skin hydrated and moisturized while you're cleansing. That's a huge thing for me because if I use anything foamy, it just completely strips my skin of all of its natural oils. And trust me, I do not have that much natural oil. So this product is an amazing price. This is $15.99. This is their value size. It's 19 ounces. That comes out to 84 cents per ounce. This one is just as good as the Dermalogica, and it is nearly $7 cheaper. So by all means, if you are living on a budget right now and you just need something that's going to be really good for the skin and gentle on your wallet, go for this one. I did find one even cheaper though than the CeraVe, and that's by St. Ives. This is the St. Ives Soothing Daily Facial Cleanser. This product has completely taken me by surprise. I really didn't think I was that big of a fan of St. Ives, but it's hard to see, but the product right now is right about here. So I've used quite a bit of this so far. This is not a foamy cleanser, and it really is incredibly gentle on the skin. This one is even cheaper than the CeraVe. St. Ives retails for $4.49. It is 6.76 ounces. That comes out to 66 cents per ounce. And you know what? I use it. I love it. I recommend it. The last cleanser that I recommend, and don't go anywhere because I do want to show you the three that are just terrible, is by the Inky List. This is their Oat Cleansing Balm. I cannot talk about this product enough. I have mentioned it in a previous video. I also do have it on my Instagram, and I get DMs about this one all the time. Now, this particular product is $9.99. Just had to look at my notes. It is 5 ounces, and that comes out to $1.99 per ounce. Amazing price. What I love is that it's oat-based, and oat is a very calming ingredient for the skin. And that's a great ingredient to have, especially in the warmer, hotter months when you're a little bit more exposed to the sun. So this one, another fantastic cleanser. So those were the 5 products that I absolutely loved, but I did find 3 that were just terrible for me. And the first 2 are by Dove. Now, I wanted to find things from the supermarket, so I picked these 2 up. This is the Dove Beauty Moisture Conditioning Facial Cleanser and the Dove Inner Glow Gentle Exfoliating Facial Cleanser. The ingredients in these ones aren't bad, but at the same time, when I used these 2 products, they just stripped my skin. I felt like I was using a very low quality facial cleanser, and my skin didn't like it. It felt itchy afterwards, and I used these separately, not together. But I just had an overall very poor experience with these products, so I do not recommend them. The last product that I did not like, I did receive in PR from a Sephora event here in Dubai before the quarantine started, and this is the Pixi Retinol Jasmine Cleanser. I really wanted to like this product because I do get asked about Pixi all the time, but to be honest, the first warning sign, the first red flag was the fact that it contains retinol. What's that about? Because I'm just washing it off my skin anyways. So that was kind of weird, but I thought, you know what, I'll give it a try. It has ceramides in it. Ceramides are incredibly moisturizing to the skin. They're in a lot of the other products I just showed you. And overall, the ingredients weren't bad. All of these products I'm showing you do contain some sort of natural ingredients from plant extracts. And when it comes to a face wash, I don't mind if my face wash has natural fragrance in it because I am washing it off my face anyways. But I could not get past the scent. It's terrible. And it's the jasmine. I love the scent of jasmine. I think it's a beautiful scent, but it smells very off with this product. And also it was just, it's too overpowering. It's too much. And my skin afterwards felt the same way my skin did with the Dove. So I just felt like my skin was itchy, dry, and my skin said, please stop using this. So after researching all these ingredients and trialing all of these different cleansers out, my husband told me yesterday that he had some good news for me and that his full salary is being reinstated next month. I am so grateful, so incredibly grateful. And now that I have found so many great products, there is no way I'm ever spending $39 on a cleanser again. Why would I? So I am going to be having a blast with my budget cleansers that I absolutely love, and I'm going to continue saving money. If you love to save money, by all means, check out my video right here on wallet-friendly beauty finds. I have in this video products that I discovered last month, some skincare, some makeup, some hair care, and at the end, I do also have another find from last month that has nothing to do with beauty, but gives you a little bit more insight into who I am as a person. So I'll see you over there.